Hello students, today's topic is linear differential equations. Firstly, we'll see linear algebraic equations. You know, linear algebraic equations are algebraic equations of degree 1. Their degree is 1, highest power of the variable is 1. So this is a linear equation in algebra. Same here. Linear differential equation. I am writing here some differential equations. Dy by dx is equal to 7 minus sin xy. Second equation, dy by dx equals to x log x minus 2 upon xy. Third equation, cos square x dy by dx plus y equals to 10x. Fourth equation, dy by dx into y plus 7 is equal to cos x. Here we are observing differential equation 1 is first order and first degree differential equation. Here order of the derivative is 1, so order of the differential equation is 1 and its degree is also 1. Here y is the dependent variable and x is independent variable. Same here, this is also first order first degree differential equation. This is also first order first degree differential equation. So 1, 2, 3 are linear differential equations. These are linear differential equations. Now fourth one is here, dy upon dx into y. These two terms appears with mutual multiplication. So this is not a linear differential equation. This is not a linear differential equation. So if y and its derivative appears in separate terms, here dy by dx and y appears in separate terms with degree 1, and other expressions are constants or functions of x, right? Here also dy upon dx and y appears with degree 1 in separate terms, and other expressions are functions of x or constants. So 1, 2, 3 are linear differential equations. Fourth one is not a linear differential equation. This type of term should not appear in the differential equation. Now we see the general form of the differential equation. General form, general standard form. If we write dy by dx plus py equals to q, this is general linear differential equation, right? Dy upon dx and y appears in separate terms with degree 1. And p and q are constants or functions of x, where p and q are constants or functions of x. If we write dx upon dy, here x is dependent variable and y is independent variable, plus px equals to q. This is also general form of a differential equation of second type. This is also linear differential equation. But this form is removed from your syllabus. So we have to study only first case, right? We will solve questions based on this type. In the second case, P and Q are functions of Y or constant. Here, Y is the independent variable and X is dependent variable. In the first case, X was independent variable and Y was dependent variable, and P and Q were functions of X or constants, right? Now we see how to solve linear differential equation. We know that in differential equation, derivatives appears. To remove derivatives, we have to integrate it to find its solutions. As solution is a relationship between X and Y along with arbitrary constants. That will give us general solution, right? So if we multiply first form dy upon dx plus py equals to q by e to the power integral p dx. Multiply both sides, multiplying both sides by this expression. So e raised to the power integral p dx dy upon dx plus, here also we multiply, so y into p e to the power integral p dx equals to q into e to the power integral p dx. Now what will happen? The left side, left expression is derivative of some expression or a product expression, product function, right? Now we will see which type of function that is. So here, if we treat e to the power integral p dx as first function, this is first function, and y is second function. This is second function. So here we are observing, this is product rule. First function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. This is derivative of e to the power integral p dx. How this is possible? Y into, we can write here dy dx of e to the power integral p dx, right? E to the power integral p dx dy by dx is equal to q into e to the power integral p dx. This is exponential function. If we differentiate exponential function, we get the same term, right? And if we differentiate this, this is integration of p. P is constant. Integration of p means p into x, right? So if we differentiate p into x, we get p. Differentiation of x is 1, so its value is p, right? So derivative of this term is p into e raised to the power integral p dx. So this expression can be written as derivative of d upon dx of y into e to the power integral p dx is equal to q into e to the power integral p dx. Now we have to solve the differential equation, means we have to remove derivatives. So we integrate both the sides. If we integrate, we know that differentiation and integration are reverse process. So they cancelled out, derivative is cancelled by integral operator. So this is y into e to the power integral p dx equals to integral q into e to the power integral p dx. And if integration is over, we put a constant of integration. So this gives general solution of linear differential equation. Right? This is general solution for linear differential equation. So the expression by which we have multiplied both the terms is called integrating factor. It makes both the sides integrable. So here integrating factor is e to the power integral pdx, right? In short form, we write it as IF, integrating factor, e to the power integral pdx. In the general form, we observe that differentiation is with respect to x, right? So to find solution, we have to remove derivative. So we have to integrate with respect to x. So this is a clue for finding integrating factor. We have to integrate with respect to x. So this is integrating factor, IF. Now, we will solve some questions based on the topic linear differential equations. Exercise 9.6, question number 1. Exercise 9.6, first question. Question is, find the general solution of dy by dx plus 2y is equal to sin x. Firstly, we compare it with general linear differential equation, dy by dx plus py equals to q. First step is we have to identify p and q. In the second step, we will calculate, evaluate integrating factor. Then in third step, we find general solution of the linear differential equation. So here, coefficient of y is p. Before identifying p and q, we have to check whether the differential equation is in standard form or not. Standard form means coefficient of dy upon dx must be 1. So here it is already 1. So this is in standard form. If it is not 1, firstly we have to make it 1, right? Then we will identify p and q. So the coefficient of y is p, and the expression or constant on the right side is q. So here p equals to 2 and q equals to sin x. So we will calculate integrating factor. Integrating factor is e raised to the power integral pdx, means e raised to the power 2dx. 2 is constant, take it outside. E raised to the power 2, integration of 1 is x, e to the power 2x. Therefore, general solution is firstly, we'll write the formula y into, if we solve the differential equation, remove derivative. From dy upon dx, we get y. So we have to start from y. Y into integrating factor equals to integral q into integrating factor whole dx plus constant of integration. This is general solution. So y into e raised to the power 2x, e raised to the power 2x, q, q is sin x, e raised to the power 2x plus constant of integration. We can put c later on after integration is over. y into e to the power 2x equals 2. Here we have to integrate this expression. This is product of two terms, two functions. So we have to apply here by parts method, right? So this is non-terminating type expression. So we will consider it as I1, right? This whole integral is I1, and we calculate I1 separately and then we put the value. So this is I1 plus C, equation 1. Now consider I1 sin x e raised to the power 2x dx. We calculate its value separately, then we put value of I1 in equation 1 to find general solution of the given differential equation. So here it is a product function, so using by parts method, this is first function, this is second function. So using formula, first function, integration of second function minus integral derivative of first function, integral of second function plus constant of integration. Sin x, here e to the power 2x is composite function, exponential function of 2x. So firstly we'll integrate exponential function with the same expression, so its integral is same, e to the power 2x, then we evaluate this 2x, or we can substitute value of 2x is equal to t. So 2 dx equals to dt means dx is equal to dt upon 2. So the expression is divided by 2, 1 by 2 minus differentiation of sin x is cos x, integration of e to the power 2x is e to the power 2x divided by 2. We take 1 by 2 outside. So this is 1 by 2 sin x e raised to the power 2x minus 1 by 2. Again, this is integration of product function. So we'll take first function and second function and again apply by parts method. So put a bracket, cos x, integration of e raised to the power 2x minus integral derivative of cos x, integral of e to the power 2x whole dx plus constant of integration. 1 by 2 sin x e raised to the power 2x minus 1 by 2. Integration of e raised to the power 2x is same, e to the power 2x by 2. So this is cos x, e to the power 2x divided by 2 minus integral. Differentiation of cos x is minus sin x, e to the power 2x upon 2 dx, whole dx plus c. 1 by 2 sin x e to the power 2x minus multiply by 1 by 2. So this is also by minus 1. So 1 by 4 cos x e raised to the power 2x minus into minus plus plus into minus minus. So 1 by 4 integral sin x e raised to the power 2x dx plus constant of integration. Here we are observing inside the integral sign, we get the same expression, same function that is given in I1. Integrand is same. So we can express it again by I1. It is non-terminating. So we shift this term to the left to combine terms with I1 so that we can find value of I1. I1 equals to, this is minus 1 by 4 I1, right? This whole is I1. So minus 1 by 4 I1, we transpose it to left. So plus 1 by 4 I1 equals to 1 by 2 sin x e raised to the power 2x minus 1 by 4 cos x e raised to the power 2x. We take here LCM also. Here also, so 1 plus 1 by 4 whole into I1 is 5 by 4 I1 equals to, we are taking LCM, 2 sin x, and taking e to the power 2x common from these two terms. So this is 2 sin x minus cos x whole into e to the power 2x. Plus C. So we can cancel out this 4, and 4 is multiplied here, and 4 into C is again a constant, so we can put that constant as C dash. So this is I1 equals to 5 by 4 into 1 by 4, no, sorry, 4 by 5. This is 4 by 5 into 1 by 4. 4 cancel. 2 sin x minus cos x e raised to the power 2x plus here also 4 by 5 into c, that is c dash. So this is value of I1. I1 equals to 1 upon 5. 2 sin x minus cos x e raised to the power 2x, right, plus c dash. Now we put this value in 1. Putting this value in 1, 1 was y into e to the power 2x plus I1 equal plus c equals to I1 plus c, here putting value of I1. Therefore, general solution is y e to the power 2x equals to 1 upon 5, 2 sin x minus cos x e to the power 2x plus c dash plus c. We can put it by another constant and we can divide by e to the power 2x, right? So y 1 upon 5 2 sin x minus cos x e to the power 2x cancelled from this term, and we are putting another constant for this, suppose c1, right? So c1 into e to the power minus 2x, c1 divided by e to the power 2x, and we transpose it to numerator. So this is c1 into e to the power minus 2x. This is general solution answer. Now we come to next question. Question number 4. Question number 4 is, dy by dx plus sec xy equals to tan x, where 0 lesser than or equal x less than pi by 2. This is given for the definition of sec x and tan x. So here this is also a linear differential equation. Y and dy by dx are appearing in separate terms with 1 degree. and other functions are functions of x. So this is of the form dy upon dx plus py equals to q. So coefficient of y is p. It is already in standard form. Coefficient of dy upon dx is 1. So coefficient of y is p. So here p equals to sec x and q is equal to tan x. Right? So integrating factor is e raised to the power integral p dx. E raised to the power integral sec x dx. So e raised to the power integration of sec x is log of sec x plus tan x. Log mod sec x plus tan x. Now sec x and tan x both are positive in first quadrant. This is first quadrant. So sum of two positive values is positive. So we can remove this mod. So this is an e log cancelled. So this is sec x plus tan x. Now solution, general solution is given by y into integrating factor is equal to q into integrating factor whole dx plus constant of integration. So y into sec x plus tan x is equal to q. Q is on the right side, we are given 10x. So this is 10x into sec x plus 10x dx. Now we have to do integration on the right side to find its general solution. So make the terms integrable. First term is sec into 10, sec x into 10x. Separating integrals. And second term is tan into 10, that is tan square x. Sec x into 10x is integrable, but tan square x is not integrable. So using identity tan square x equals to sec square x minus 1, we make it integrable. Sec x into 10x dx plus sec square x minus 1 dx. Integration of sec into 10 is sec x . Now integration of sec square x minus integration of integration of 1 is x. Sec x plus integration of sec square x is 10x plus constant of integration. So y into sec x plus 10x is equal to sec x plus 10x minus x plus c. So this is answer, general solution of the given differential equation. Now the seventh question, exercise 5.6, question number 9.6, question number 7. This is x log x dy by dx plus y is equal to 2 upon x log x. Here we are observing coefficient of dy upon dx is not 1. So we divide the whole expression, both the sides, by x into log x. So dividing both sides by x log x. So dy by dx plus 1 by x log x y 2 log x upon x log x x square. 1x is already here, one more x is multiplied here, so this is x square. Log x cancelled. So dy by dx. Now differential equation is in standard form. Right. So coefficient of y is p. This is p. And this is q. So integrating factor is e to the power integral p dx. E raised to the power 1 upon x log x dx. Log x is not integrable, so we put here log x equals to t. Put log x equals to t, then its derivative is 1 by x. So 1 by x dx equals to dt. So we have here 1 by x dx. So this is dt upon t, that is log t, right? So e raised to the power dt upon t means e raised to the power log t. Log t, e and log removed. So this is modulus of t and t is log x. So this is log x. Integrating factor is log x. So we will write solution. Solution is general solution. Y into integrating factor is equal to q into integrating factor whole integral plus constant of integration. Y into log x q. Q is 2 upon x square. Into log x dx. Plus constant of integration. So here we have to evaluate right side integration of this expression. So we put log x equals to 2 as log x is not integrable. So putting log x equals to 2. This is on the natural base. So x equals to e to the power t means, and 1 by x dx equals to dt. So here we have 1 by x. So we take 2 outside. 1 by x dx becomes dt. And 1 by x is remaining here. 2. 1 by x log x. 1 by x dx. This is dt. Log x is t. And x is e to the power t. So this is t into e raised to the power minus t. Right side is 2 t e raised to the power minus t dt plus constant of integration. Now this is a product function. So we apply by parts method, taking t first function and e raised to the power minus t second function. So this is 2 whole into t into integration of e to the power minus t minus integral dy dt of t integral e to the power minus t dt plus constant of integration. this is equal to 2t integration of e to the power minus t. Here minus t, suppose u, then minus dt equals to du, dt equals to minus du. So this is e to the power u du into minus 1. So we multiply here minus 1. So this is minus of t e to the power minus t. Minus dt by dt is 1. And this is minus of e to the power minus t plus constant of integration. So 2 whole into minus t e to the power minus t, this is plus e to the power minus t dt to minus t e to the power minus t. Again, integration of e to the power minus t is minus of e to the power minus t plus constant of integration. Now integration is over. We have to simplify the expression. So left side is y log x . Here we can put modulus also. Y log x, 2 replacing t. T was log x. So this is minus of log x. Or we can take it with modulus x. E raised to the power minus t is 1 by x plus constant of integration. Taking 1 by x outside, y into log of modulus of x, 2 by x, taking minus 1 also outside, log of modulus of x plus 1 plus, so this is general solution answer. Now come to question number 16. Question number 16. Question 16 is, let's find equation of a curve passing through origin 0, 0, given that slope of the tangent at any point x, y is equal to sum of the coordinates x plus y. X and y are coordinates of the point. So this is given, and we know that slope of the tangent is given by derivative dy upon dx at x, y. So this is equal to x plus y. So dy by dx minus y equals to x. This is linear differential equation. We have to find its general solution. We know that general solution gives family of curves, right? And we have to find a particular curve which passes through 0, 0 out of that family of curves. So we put 0, 0 in the general solution to get value of c, and by putting the particular value of c to general solution, we get the required answer, means particular curve. equation of the particular curve. So equation is in general form. We find integrating factor. Integrating factor is e raised to the power integral p dx. Here p is minus 1, coefficient of y, and q is x. Right? This is p and this is q. The p dx e raised to the power minus 1 dx, that is e raised to the power minus x. Integration of 1 is x, taking minus common. This is e raised to the power minus x. So general solution is given by y into integrating factor q, q is x, x into e raised to the power minus x dx plus constant of integration. It is again a product function, so we will evaluate the integral by using five parts method. First function, second function. So x into integral of e to the power minus x minus integral differential of x integral of e to the power minus x, then again integration of the whole expression and constant of integration. So general solution is y e to the power minus x is equal to x integration of e to the power minus x, minus 1 is extra, so in integration the extra constant divide the integration. So this is e to the power minus x upon minus 1 or minus of e to the power minus x. Minus of differential of x is 1, e raised to the power minus x upon minus 1 or minus of e to the power x plus constant of integration. Minus x e raised to the power minus x, minus into minus is plus, e raised to integral e to the power minus x. So this is minus of x e to the power minus x minus of e raised to the power minus x plus constant of integration. Now this is general solution, or we can say family of curves. Now we have to find a particular curve that passes through 0, 0. Means we should put x equals to 0 and y equals to 0 to evaluate particular value of c. So 0 e to the power minus 0 minus of 0 e to the power minus 0 minus e to the power minus 0 plus c. E to the power minus 0 is 1 upon e to the power 0, means 1 upon 1. Due to this 0, this is 0. This is also 0. And this is minus of 1. It means value of c equals to 1. Putting this value of c in the general solution, this is general solution. This gives us required equation of the curve. Therefore, required equation is y e raised to the power minus x equals to minus of x e raised to the power minus x minus e raised to the power minus x plus 1. We can cancel out e raised to the power minus x from each term. Here it is divided, 1 is divided by e to the power minus x. So it will give us y equals to minus of x, e to the power minus x cancelled, here also cancelled, so minus 1 plus 1 upon e to the power minus x. 1 upon e to the power minus x is 1 into e to the power x, right? So this is y equals to e to the power x minus 1. This is required answer